things. Today we will discuss about the light part 3 and chapter name is what? Spherical mirror. In previous class where we study about the plane mirror, we study about the light. Today we will discuss about the spherical mirror. In the previous video I have told you that mirror are the two types. One is plane mirror and another is spherical mirror. Plane mirror and spherical mirror. What is that plane mirror? You have seen in the previous videos that plane mirror has the flat surface, reflective surface. Yes, I have already told you about its characteristics and its uses. Yes, we have seen the video. Part 2 and 3 videos in your videos, and today we will study about this one, spherical videos. So spherical means what? Spherical, here is the word of the spherical mirror, the mirror whose reflecting surface are curved. It means keep on the sphere, here it's got the half parts. Yeah, it's called the half one, and it forms what? Like as a cone. You have seen, this is a cone. This, in a way, when you cut it like this cone. Yes or no? Hence, the cone in a spherical, cone in shape means the mirror whose reflecting surface are called spherical mirror. Now I will show you that the cone mirror, the reflecting surface and one is the polished surface. The transparent, it is the formation of the glass and both sides are transparent. But when one side is coated with mercury or the silver polished, then another side will become what? The reflecting surface. Then the side will become what? Reflecting surface. So here one side is coated with mercury or the silver coated, whereas one side is reflecting side. Here I have drawn the two figure. Yes, figure number 1 and figure number 2. Means a spherical mirror are mainly the two types. Spherical mirror two types. Means one is the cone mirror, another is convex mirror. Concave mirror and convex mirror. So spherical mirror two types. One is concave mirror and it is convex mirror. What is that concave mirror and the convex mirror? How we can identify? Yes, what is the way for identifying? What is the uses of concave mirror and the convex mirror? Here is the main questions. Yes, where we have to use the concave mirror, where we have to use the convex mirror. So now I will show you the concave and the convex mirror both of them. So this is some of these. It is the inner, you have seen this figure. The inner surface are polished, another is outer side surface are polished. Outer surface and the inner surface. You have seen the outer surface which is polished. That is the concave mirror. And when the inner surface is polished, that is the convex mirror. First of all, I am showing you how we have to identify concave mirror and the convex mirror. You have seen, here is the, once again I will show you the spherical mirror, how this concave and the convex mirror are. Let me say, This is the carbocyte.
Yes.
This is the carbocyte. When the carbocyte, this is the carbocyte element. When the outer surface is polished or coated with mercury or the silver, and then this types of mirror is concave mirror. Outer of the outside of the curve. This is the curved surface like this, and this is out. When the out of this spherical mirror space is coated, it is the concave mirror. Remember these things. This is a concave mirror. And when the inner surface, now this is the what? Curved side. This is the curved mirror. Yes. And when its inner part, when this inner part is polished with silver or the mercury, that is the what? Convex mirror. What is that? Convex mirror. This is a convex mirror, and this is a concave mirror. So remind these both things, which one is the concave mirror and which one is the convex mirror. Now I will show you. What is the definition? How you can define the concave mirror? Concave mirror means, if the reflecting surface is curved inwards, reflecting surface would be curved inwards. This is the inwards, this is outwards. If the reflecting surface is curved inward, reflecting surface, this is the polished surface. Yes, we have seen that it is silver coated. Outward is silver coated, and inward is reflecting surface. So inward and the outward is what? Silver. It is called the concave mirror. Then what is the picture meaning of concave mirror? The mirror in which the reflecting surface is curved and outside of this is what? Polished or silver coated. That is called what? Concave mirror. You have seen in this concave mirror, the reflecting objects are kept in this side, in the reflecting side, because this is the one, this is the inward, and inward is the reflecting surface. This is the reflecting surface. Because in this side, we will keep the one object. Object should be kept. What? In the reflecting side. We should not keep the object to the polished side. Then the image cannot be formed. So, where we have to keep? On the reflecting side of the object should be kept. I will also explain you about some tops of this mirror. So don't worry, try to understand which one is the concave mirror. So what is that concave mirror? Inner side is the curved side, is reflecting side, and outwards is polished. That is the what? Concave mirror. This concave mirror is also known as this concave mirror is also known as the converging mirror. This concave mirror is also known as what? Converging mirror. Because this converge all the beam of light at a point. It means because it conserves the light rays falling on it. It's when I will show you some diagrams of a lot of this, you have seen this is the concave mirror and this is the object is kept. Yes, when the object is kept, it conserves. It what? It will be all the ray of the light conserved at a point, it passing from the focus, and it conserved at the two ray of light are conserved and meet at a point. Okay, that means this shows that this converse what? Concave mirror is also known as the what? Conserving what? Mirror. Okay, now convex mirror. Okay, now convex mirror. What is that convex mirror? If the reflecting surface is curved outside, reflecting surface is curved outside, and the inside is silver, that is called convex mirror. Now you have seen in the concave mirror just opposite, in concave mirror and in convex mirror. In convex mirror, what happened? The curved side is polished. You have seen this is the curved side. Curved side. Whatever. Curved side is polished and outside is reflected. This is the what? Reflecting. Reflecting surface. This is the reflecting surface. Outside is the reflecting surface. It means inside the spherical mirror, inside it is a polished. Yes? And outside is our reflecting. So where the object is should be kept? Object should be kept order in this position. Where? In this position, not inside this. When you keep the inside, this side, the object, this side is a polished, the image cannot be formed. So you have to keep the outside of the object. Where? In a convex mirror. So what is the meaning of convex mirror? If the reflecting surface is curved outside and the inside is silver, that is called convex mirror. It is also known as the diverging mirror. Diverging means it is scattered. Yes, it is diverges the image. So it because it diverges the ray of the light, incidence and the reflecting surface. Because it diverges the light ray incident on its reflecting surface. And what is incident ray? What is reflected ray? What is normal? Yes, we have to. We have already studied about in grade 7 also, in 6 also. What is the incident ray, reflected ray, normal? Okay, and angle of incidence, angle of reflections. Yes, today I will give you the some short about this. About the their reflections, what is that? Do you understand this convex and concave mirror? If you have any problem, please comment with me. Okay. Now I will show you the reflection of light. How this reflection of the mirror occurs? Reflection of light. Now, this is a plane mirror. This is a polished surface. What is XY is plane mirror. Okay, XY is what? Plane mirror. When any ray incidentally falls on the plane mirror, suppose this is the P and this is the O. When any ray falls on the plane mirror, yes, that is what? Incident ray. It means PO is incident ray. What is PO is incident ray. And it reflected back in the same way, that is Q. It means OQ. OQ is a reflected ray. Reflected ray. PO is incident ray and OQ is a reflected ray. Now, a perpendicular line drawn from the angle between this. This is the M. It means NO. NO is normal ray. What is normal? NO is what? Normal ray. Now, what? This angle, the angle between PON, angle PON is angle of incidence. What is angle of incidence, where N O Q, angle N O Q is angle of reflection. Angle of reflection. It means when the ray of the light comes and it reflected back. Yes, this is a what? Once again, imagine P O is the incidence ray, O Q is a reflected ray, N O is a normal ray, and Y is a plane mirror. Now, why an incidence ray forms a reflected ray forms an angle? Angle P O N is the angle of incidence, and N O Q is the angle of reflections. Now, according to the law of reflection of the light, according to the law of reflection of light, there will be two laws. According to the reflection of light, law of the reflection of light, two. One is means incidence ray, reflected ray, normal, that is all light in the same plane at the point O. Point O. Incidence ray, reflected ray, normal, all light in the same plane at the point of O. Yes, point of incidence. This is the what? Point of incidence. Point of incidence where the incidence ray strikes the surface. That is the point of incidence. All light at the point of incidence. Second law is what? Angle of incidence. That is R. It is denoted by R. And angle of reflections are always equal. It means sine, it means I is equal to R. Angle, I is equal to angle R. Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. It means, this, suppose this is a 30 degree, this must be 30 degree. Okay? It will be 40 degree, then there must be the 40 degree. So, these things you have already studied. So, remind these things. And you have to read more and more in your home also. Okay, thank you.